Again, this is Jeff with FamilyGoKarts.com. What we're going to want to do is show you some of the features of a larger ATV that you get from us. Before showing you also some steps to look at before you start up, like this unit here. This is a T250 DSU. Several of the things that we're going to show you here today will work with your other full-size units, like your T125 FX1. Your T150BX, your T150GX, and your 300 unit. So let's start here and look at some of the features of this unit that you need to look at before setting it up. Come down here. First thing I want to show you is this is your carburetor on this unit, and underneath there you will see a breather tube, and that breather tube goes on this unit. In most units, to the back, and you just let it. There's that breather tube. I'm trying to shine light on it right there, so it just stays open. It does not hook to anything. That's the key point I want to cover there. Next thing I want to talk about is we'll go along the side of the unit. This is your starter. Always want to make sure that there's no loose bolts or anything like that with your starter. This here. On this side of the unit is your stator. This is what produces spark, what's behind this plate. Do not put any engine oil, transmission oil, or any type of oil in this whatsoever. Behind this plate, make sure these bolts are tight. Behind this plate is your engine sprocket. This unit on the T250 DSU is a manual clutch. So this is your shifter. What if you see this is cut out, we've done that ourselves. We find if you cut this out, it's just a little easier to shift this and stay easier to shift in gear. We go to the front of the unit where we're going to see. We always want to also check the front shocks, make sure everything's tight here, your A-arms, make sure nothing's loose there. Here's your wiring bundle. On some of the units, you'll have two or three wires that are not hooked up to anything, and that's okay because Tao uses their wire bundles for several of the units, and some of the wires you do not hook up. So check your bolts, make sure all this stuff is tight here before starting it. Your tie rod, you got your tie rods here. Let's go to the other side of the unit. And here's another breather tube. Right here, off the exhaust, is another breather tube. This does not hook to anything. We choose, and several times Tao do that too and other manufacturers, hook it right up here. This gets out of the way, make sure it's not laying on the exhaust or anything like that. We come around to the back side of the engine. What we're going to want to do is show you the spark plug, make sure the unit has a spark plug, and make sure the spark plug cap is on. Make sure everything is good there and so forth. Then what I want to do is show you the fuel line. I don't know which way it is going to be better. Let's look down underneath here. Come up to the front of the ATV. If we look, this is our gas tank. There is no fuel shut off on the gas tank. And then we hook it up. We'll go on the other side and show you where the fuel line. You always want to check to make sure the fuel line's on before putting gas in. And if we follow that, make sure your unit has a fuel filter. There's the fuel filter there. We highly recommend you go down to a parts store and spend $3-4 and get a very, very high quality fuel filter, because that'll save you a lot of headaches. And right here, this is your fuel line, and this is where it's hooked up to be. Now this unit, so your fuel line is hooked up to the left side of your carburetor as sitting on the ATV. This here is your choke. If you come up to the handlebar on the bigger models, your choke's right there. We just to share that with you. Let's go to the back of the ATV. You're going to want to check out the whole ATV, make sure nothing is loose. You're going to check the exhaust bolts that we showed at the beginning, your shocks. You got your top, make sure those bolts are good. These are good. Make sure your disc brakes are good. Make sure your axle bolts are good. So this just gives you, check everything out. We're not looking to over tighten anything. We're just making sure nothing vibrated loose during shipping. Chain, this has a really good, this is proper tightness of the chain. If it's tighter than that, you can ruin the front sprocket and the splines on the front sprocket. And so you do not want this any tighter. If you come back here, make sure your brake sensor and assembly here, make sure that is tight and not loose. Let's talk about engine oil. Over on the right side is where you put the oil, right here. Some of the units that have this cut out already, others don't. You can cut it, it makes it a lot easier access to it. This is where you put your engine oil. On most of your ATVs, your engine oil also lubricates your drive system. This is your foot brake also. I think we are good. We talked about the air filter, so we're good. So I wanted to just show you some of the things about your ATV. If you have any questions, you can reach us at tech@familygokarts.com. Thank you so much and appreciate your purchase. Take care. Thank you for stopping at familygokarts.com. We're going to demonstrate to you starting the 250 DSU. First of all, what you want to do is turn the key on. You turn that way. That engages the on button. This here is your brake. Your hand brake will have to be engage when you start the ATV up, and we'll do that in a minute. Over here, this is your clutch. You also have to hold in the clutch when you start it. And this here is your choke. If your unit has not ran for a while, you're going to have to choke it. You choke it by moving the lever all the way out. This button here is your start button. We'll press on that when we're ready to start. And this is your off and on button. This is off, either way is off. So you put it in the center and you push in to start the ATV. If you do not push it in, your ATV will not start. So what we have to do is hold in the clutch, hold in the brakes, and then we're going to hit the start. And there we go. And it's best to start your T250 DSU in neutral, but you still want to get a habit of holding the clutch. Thank you. Thank you.